Kickback. It's the Kickback, you know what I'm saying? Louis Bell, Teddy Ray. We got another special guest, man. You know, the one and only, the legendary. You know what I'm saying? Slink Johnson, man. God damn it, man. We need to get some people to come and clap the niggas or something. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Very talented dude, businessman, my young partner, man, 2-11, man. But shout out to y'all. You know, no applause needed because just the invitation to come kick back is tells me, you know, it's roses enough for me.
Oh, yeah, man. It's a pleasure you coming on the Kickback Chopping Game with us, you know what I'm saying?
You know the exclusivity you have to be invited to a kickback?
Yes.
Everybody got to verify that you're not a weird nigga for you to even be at a kickback. This kickback is just code word for we finna all get some pussy and break off. But we want to make it a chill vibe. You know, we ain't can't be no overly. So this is people that we have a vibe with.
You got to be somebody that's saucy to just kick back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Man, you know what? I'm dripping, man. Oh, wait. I'm not dripping, but...
You got the drip. You see me, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? I feel like Slick just was like, oh, okay, my nephews called me today. Nigga, let me put some
clean on. And it's fucked up, man. Y'all be calling me nephew, and I still be liking the bitches. Y'all like,
it's cool, but then you okay, your age, Slick, and the type of nigga, like a middle aged nigga with his life together. It's like the cream of the crop.
I be forgetting you an OG, Slink. You be like an OG. You be unk to me some days, and then sometimes I be like, nigga, I older than you, nigga. You be like brothers and uncles, like same person, but it's like today, this nigga my brother. And then the next time, it's like, this unk.
Slink made me feel old last year on the road trip. This nigga's full of energy. He up. He the first nigga up, and the last nigga to like knock out.
We have to address this. One thing about Slink Johnson, man, this nigga is somebody that done a little bit of everything cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I found something out that, recently I found something out about you. You a rapper, nigga. I didn't know you rap back in the day.
Absolutely.
I didn't know that. I had to find that out through the grapevine.
That's kind of disrespectful to just say rapper. Hella nigga spit bars.
Nah, but Slink wasn't that. He was legit. He was. He's still legit.
Rapper, and coincidentally, he was signed where we at Too Short. He was signed to Short Dog Records.
Do the fans, do the people know that? Have you ever talked about that?
I mean, I talk about it all the time, Lou. I think some of my earlier fans, I'm sure most of them though, and I'm sure the people that were fans of me as a rapper, you know, I'm sure they know as well. But you know, again, I've been blessed to Too Short must have rubbed off on me because I've been blessed to be able to that longevity and be able to relate to generations.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So now another generation of people are becoming introduced to me, and you know, they seeing me and, oh, it's Lamar. You know what I'm saying?
I'm pretty sure it's kids that hear your voice in public and trip. Like, how do I know him?
Yeah.
How do I know him? They 5, 6 years old. So
they can't tell if it's the voice from GTA or the voice they hear at 3 a.m. in the morning talking to them.
You do sound
like a hella OGs. It's the same, how do I know?
Slink do got a hella OG voice, like, yeah, you know, I'm at the store right now. You know, you got that.
Pass me that light.
It sound like you be.
No, I ain't stopping at no store before I pull up.
Slink sound like the OG to tell you turn the TV down. Hey, turn that TV down. Like,
oh, my nigga. Yeah, he'll remind you what time of night it is. Don't you know it's 2 in the morning?
I can see Slink coming in the room with a red ass eyes or something. Like, calm your ass down. Like, damn. I look Slink dripping.
I just be trying to be chill, man. You know what? I consider, you know, I am a big ass kid. I acknowledge that about myself, man. You know, but at the same time, I embrace my age, man.
Yeah.
You know, and I just try to have fun and keep that youthful motherfucking, that youthful outlook on shit, man. Because I done seen and done a lot of shit, man. Thank God I'm still here to be able to talk to y'all about a lot of shit. You know, I've seen, I've done a lot of shit, good and bad.
Yeah.
And shit, man, all I gotta say is smile, nigga, because it could be worse.
Oh, mama.
Smile.
That's how you know you even really done shit, nigga. Just smile. You know what I'm saying?
I be tripping off youngsters. They be 20 years old and be so serious. Oh, fuck my life, nigga. You just started living, nigga. Hold on. What the fuck you mean? Fuck your life, man. Go wait till you go through some motherfucking financial difficulties, heartbreak, death, jail. You know what I'm saying? Go through some of all that shit, man. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about? You have a different outlook, man. And time ain't really that long. I don't want to turn this to the OG conversation, but I always want to tell
you. That's what's wrong with this motherfucking generation. Niggas ain't hearing enough information.
You see how we got quiet?
Time ain't really that long, y'all. It's like, I be tripping off youngsters, you know, y'all relationship to time. And I understand that y'all ain't really had a lot of it, so you don't know what long is. Like, oh, I've been with her for 9 months. I know her. Nigga, you don't know that bitch.
Oh, mamas. Oh, mamas.
I've been hurt. We've been together for 2 years now.
Yeah.
Nigga, I done fucked bitches for 2 years and didn't know my last name.
Facts. So I done done that.
We were just talking about that.
How long did you smash a chick before you really got to remember her name?
Yeah.
So I just say, just keep on living. My grandma used to say that, man. Keep on living. Just live a little bit, man, and quit. Like, you know, life is short, but it's long. It's weird to say, but it's short.
No, it really is long because, you, like, that's one thing, like, that tripped me out. Like, I got to know you as a comedian, and, you know, I was like, of course, before we worked, I was a fan. So, oh, Black Jesus, that's wrong. But it's like, I didn't know you had a whole nother life before this. Like, nigga, you a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? You done been through hella shit. You know what I'm saying? And I done kind of, you know, was like, damn, I done thought one thing about you, and then it's like, I got to know you. Like, man, this nigga a real nigga, bro. This shit crazy. What? So, that show you that lifelong, because it's like, nigga, I only know you from... Damn, yeah, like a good life.
And it feel like forever, though.
Yeah.
And it feel like forever. And, you know, that's just what it is, man. And, you know, life is long, man. And just enjoy it and take the shit slow. Mm-hmm. Relax. Don't be such in the rush to do shit but get your money. Mm-hmm. Don't be in the rush to do nothing too much other than that. You know what I'm saying? And even in getting your money, you know, make sure you keep your head on swivel and paying attention to what's going on.
Right.
On mamas.
It's about timing, too, and pacing. And just trusting that everything gonna be okay. I think people, when they lose hope, and that shit really fuck people's head up when they ain't got no hope for nothing.
Yeah, absolutely, and it's funny you say that, Teddy, because I always say that too. I want youngsters to understand this, man. Life is a series of it's an ebb and flow, a series of plateaus and valleys, you know what I'm saying? And understand this, man, shit gonna get bad. And in my years of life, I always tell myself this when I come across a bad situation, how many times did you deal with some shit that you thought your life was gonna be over? It's gonna be all fucked up. Oh, Lord, it's this. Oh, and look at you today, nigga.
Right.
Yeah. You all right, nigga.
Yeah.
It probably was some bullshit, so you gonna be all right, nigga.
Just because the nigga stopped replying to you.
Just relax, man. Now that nigga wasn't even worth it anyway, baby. That nigga, it wasn't even that nigga car.
Okay.
Man.
What are you talking to me? I suffocate with you. What happened to my nigga
John? That nigga made that flap and got up out of there.
Man.
Yeah, that was Houston stabbed himself in the eye. That was Houston, right?
Wow.
I mixed the niggas. Jay Holiday niggas, you can get in my bed.
Yeah.
You can get in my bed.
Oh, niggas, stay fucking up the words. You can get in my bed.
You can get in my bed. Don't get this motherfucker, bitch. You know what I'm talking about? Matter of fact, don't get in my bed, bitch. We gonna get a tail. I don't know where you been, bitch.
Wow.
Yo, these bitches.
That's hella funny.
That's like wrong living.
Speaking of that shit, that pandemic, that's what the fuck motherfuckers really need to realize, too. This pandemic got everybody feeling like, nigga, life is hella hard. And how you feel like doing this pandemic? Like, how things been for you personally?
You know, I'm affected like everybody else is, Lou. Mm-hmm. I want shit to be back open. I want to go back to bars and clubs and parties and, you know, out, you know, public places and not fuck this mask. I feel the same way. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I'm whistling like motherfuckers. I ain't tripping. Because I'm free, nigga. If you ever been to jail, I'm not giving a fuck with the mask. Put the mask on. Fuck it. You know what I'm talking about? I like the mask.
That nigga said, if you ever been to jail, I am not tripping on this mask.
I'm tripping on this mask, man. Put the mask on. I'm cool. The mask is, I like the mask. Yeah. The mask, even the playing field, not all the bitches in the same. It's an ass contest now. Fuck with your face.
Ass
like,
contest.
Man, it's just an ass contest. So I'm pleased. I'm whistling.
I've been looking at everybody. I'm like, this, I'm calling bitches bad before they even, you know what I'm saying, present themselves the right way.
All you gotta set the line now is, damn them eyes.
Bad bitches is winning. I mean, ugly damn bitches is eyes. Winning right now.
Ugly bitches going up.
Right ugly now. Bitches with ass, they going up. So, look, if these niggas holler at you and they don't ask you to take off your mask. If a nigga really care, he gonna ask, hey, girl, let me see what you look like. These niggas ain't even asking. Oh, and these bitches don't even care. They just pull it up some more. Like, Tanisha.
They gonna show you the Instagram.
Tight bitches pressed down at the top.
I can't pull down my mask, but this is my Instagram right here.
It's all filtered up.
Yeah.
And then you really see her at the house during breakfast with that sunrise hour light.
Them bitches don't really be all that, my nigga.
How's the shows been? How the shows been? Because I've been performing during the pandemic, the live streaming shows. Like, the Young OG. Shout out to all the people that's supporting the Young OG comedy show, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate y'all. Appreciate y'all. That shit been entertaining, but that shit really hard. It's been like, man, it's been good, but it's like, man, it's the hardest show around.
Got something on their mind.
It's definitely a comedian's learning a new skill set, and I think it's a great time for stand-up comics because it allows us, because that fucking internet stand-up, that internet show, that shit is something different because, you know, again, I'm coming in, I'm just adjusting to, you know, getting on stage, I'm still considering myself getting my stage legs, putting my 10,000 hours in, and now the pandemic come, and it's a new way to have to do comedy, and I think it actually sharpens you that much more, and shout out to all the people that's doing it, man. And I don't know, I'm getting mine. This pandemic is like sink or swim, nigga. You can be scared if you want to, but I'm finna go out here and get it. And shout out to the Young OG, because these niggas is getting it and giving it proper motherfucking entertainment for the people to enjoy, man. You got real niggas right here. You got real articulate niggas right here, handsome as a motherfucker. You know what I'm talking about? And then you come over there and really charm your mama and cook a pot roast.
All we missing is one of those hats you be rocking, man. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got your hat with you today. Where the hat? Let me see the hat.
Shout out to Strong Wool, man. Yeah, shout out to Strong Wool, man.
Oh,
I didn't,
I didn't really want to do it, man, because I wanted to put this one on. Because
I didn't want to get this nigga back.
I look like a,
You look like a player, man. You look like a pimp, man.
Yeah, man, goddamn it. I feel like I'm in the 70s with this.
Hey, you get you one of them at strongwool.com, www.strongwool.com. And if you use my promo code SLINK10, you can get 10% off your purchase.
Oh, man, that's player. You feel me? I've been fucking with this move, man. I've been like,
I didn't want to wear that one. I had it, but I didn't want to put it on because I know this. I didn't want this nigga to have no memories because I know I kind of look familiar with that hat on.
Yeah.
Like somebody from the UK. He remembered. He was like, hey, your mom named Deborah.
Niggas be guessing at my face. You ever seen a kid from a nigga mom?
That's hella funny.
Like, damn. Man,
that's hella
you
21. Funny.
I bumped into you in traffic. You driving? That's crazy. I remember you had the little toy car.
You got that ass just like you want. I'm sorry.
We did do a song together. It was me. Shout out my boy Doughboy. Yeah, shout out Doughboy.
King of the Sixes.
You know what I'm saying? We did a song, King of the Sixes.
Oh, y'all did.
We was challenging with Teddy versus Doughboy, y'all. And I was
doing King of the Sixes. Matter of fact, play the clip now.
Oh, mamas, play that motherfucker for sure.
And then after that,
mm-hmm.
after that, play you and your bitch.
Oh, mama said, see who won. That was a funny ass challenge. Shout out my boy Doughboy for getting me a slink on the track.
Yeah, hell
yeah. You was gassing on that motherfucker. And then that's what I'm like, once I found out you was a rapper back in the day, it's like, oh, that's why he was gassing on that motherfucker like that. Like, what made you transition? Like, all right, like, I'm finna be a comedian. Because I didn't want to be a comedian growing up. Like, I never thought about being a comedian because I was like on my little tough shit, and I thought I don't want motherfuckers to take me as a joke.
I'm the same, Lou. I'm the same, Lou, but it took me, I didn't think about it. I didn't say, hey, I want to be a comedian. Mm-hmm. My only aspirations of that came maybe early on when I was watching Eddie Murphy as a child. Like, oh, yeah, this nigga's dope. I would love to do that. But, you know, again, it probably sat in the back of my subconscious. I ain't never like, oh, because, again, I was a rapper. I wanted to be a tough nigga.
Yeah.
I wanted to be this rapper nigga. I got the heat. I got the dope.
Hey, this nigga, not to cut you off, this nigga Slink has some of the most murderous bars. Mm-hmm. Knowing this nigga, seeing this nigga prepare meals for his family and all this shit, yeah. Watch this nigga. Make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches for his daughters and shit, like, and then hearing them bars, yeah, like, it threw me off.
Because it's two sides, to, yeah. You know what I'm saying, to most people, you know what I'm saying?
And he came from the day where you had to really make metaphors about the, now niggas just telling you what kind of gun they got, mm-hmm. and how many bullets is in it.
Yeah.
Oh, click on the 30 round. Yeah, like, yeah. You really had to tell a nigga what direction this bullet was going to enter his body.
Yeah.
The bullet entered his spleen, you know what I mean.
So I'm just so confused. Bro, how the fuck do you transition to that?
Lou, it just, you're just a light-skinned nigga fucking up.
I'm going to say we took a motherfucking lunch break.
Yeah, we did, actually.
We really did. We can start it now. It's already rolling. Hey, man, the camera cut off, man, but we back in action anyway. You know what I'm talking about? We had to take a little food break and all type of shit. You know how niggas fuck with it.
I had to hurry up behind my napkins. I was like, oh, shit, nigga. I'm gonna look like the fattest nigga. I got all the napkins and shit. I'm already the fattest nigga.
Yeah, you gotta be conscious like, of how you look. Like this. Yeah, you don't wanna look like the fat nigga because you got hella shit. Yeah, oh, but yeah, what you say, Slink, about the transition from rapping to being a comedian?
My nigga, I was saying I likened myself to what you were saying. Like, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? I wanted to be a tough guy, but it took mm-hmm. me till I got grown to understand that wasn't my lane. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? I'm a funny nigga.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a funny nigga that was given an amazing opportunity. You know what I'm saying? To be on one day, to be the lead of a hit show on Adult Swim, you know, be on the biggest video game of all time. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And Charlie Murphy prompted me like, yo, bro, take advantage of this opportunity. You funny, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But also understand that it's the difference between being a funny nigga and a stand-up comedian.
Facts.
It's a science, and this shit must be respected, and it must be, you gotta put in them hours. You just don't, you know, be funny at the barbecue, then jump and sell out a fucking crowd.
Or the internet.
Or the internet either.
Yeah.
And again, shout out to all the young guys, because, you know, most comedians nowadays that are coming up are internet comedians.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just what it is.
You kind of have to be. They kind
of...
The last comedian that didn't need the internet was Gerard Carmichael. After him, nigga, it's...
Lil Rel. That's the same umbrella.
He came before Gerard.
Uh-huh.
He was on before.
Yeah, he time. Was already doing yeah. shit. Yes, he was.
That don't count. Saying. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Gerard Carmichael.
For sure. Real,
kill it.
For sure.
Shit is definitely it's definitely a science, man. And the transition just came from opportunities being put in front of me.
So somebody just got at you like, hey, bro, I'm doing a comedy show. And you full-blown rap? Are you slowed down on the rap? Like,
I have slowed down on the rap. You know what I'm saying? Actually, to be honest with you, I kind of got a little disenchanted with it because, you know what I'm saying, it didn't work out on the timeline I wanted it to.
Yeah,
you know
yeah.
what I'm saying? That's why I'm not saying it's over. It just didn't work out on the timeline I, you know, expected to do.
But a lot of rappers need to hear that because I feel like when you start off as a rapper, it's like you can't say a person failed in rap because you could be 41 and then make a song and then now you
don't know when that hit comes. Yeah. Your life ain't over. Yeah. The motherfuckers be always, people like society, culture, young or the youth in the culture like the clown of old niggas rapping this and that and the third. Mm-hmm. Oh, you too old to be rapping. Nigga, do you understand that rap, we started the shit.
Yeah.
We were the kids doing it before you were.
Right.
And we grew and cultivated the shit and loved the shit. Yeah, I got a Landon Strip hairline now. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I got dad bod, slut gut. You know what I'm talking about? I'm missing a few teeth. I'm a little older now, but that don't take the love that I have away. And for
you
a lot of niggas.
For SSI?
Not yet. Not okay. yet.
You good.
Not yet. I'm almost. Just a few more weeks.
Whenever you need a home, like, health aid nurse, let me get that check.
Yeah, because all you're going to be doing is rolling blunts.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Like, my nigga, yeah, all right. I checked everything, the friends full, the ain't shit in there, but old piece.
Nigga, make sure he, is he high? Yeah, he good. He's high. Yeah, man, you can't stop, man. It's like,
that's but you stopped, right?
I stopped because I felt like, yeah, I stopped because I felt like opportunity was drying up and I wasn't smashing. I didn't continue to smash because life, you know, life started tumbling. The kids getting bigger, they need shit, nigga. Uh-huh. You were out here, nigga, rapping, nigga. Come on.
Kids crying, that shit.
Yeah.
But, you know, again, that kind of fucked with my spirit on it a little bit, but my personality always been my personality. And all these different things have been brewing for a long time. Like, actually, my first stand-up gig came before GTA 5. I did my first stand-up gig after I got out of county jail.
Wow.
And it was a point where, you know...
Was that a condition of your release?
Oh, nigga, you too funny.
Nah.
If you don't get your ass...
He's slick, nigga. I wasn't funny in jail.
But, nigga, I was in jail telling niggas about Black Jesus. And this was in 2011.
Wow.
Really? 2011. I would tell them because, you know, Black Jesus was already, you know, things were kind of happening already. You know, I know it had already been in Adult Swim's office, so... You know, the wheels were turning, but it was at the beginning of the process. So I'm in jail. Niggas thought I was lying. And she's like, yeah, nigga, like, Jesus, nigga, I do shit. It's gonna be on TV, nigga. Watch. Niggas look at me like, this nigga lying like a motherfucker. But
we all selling wolf tickets,
man. Yeah, but you know, again, it happened, and all this stuff had been in play. Again, like I was saying, stand up, my first time on stage was, again, fresh out of the county jail. I made an agreement with Aaron Magruder. And God, just like Puff did with Big, like, yo, if you want, you can't do this shit no more. You know, they were selling weed, and that's when it was still illegal. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You can't do this shit no more, so I couldn't do it. And I was like, damn, I ain't finna work nobody's job.
Mm-hmm.
I can't sell weed no more. I'm on my mama's couch. I'm fucking broke. I'm in a rut. And then one day, I'm like, I'm just gonna go do some. Because I had already, you know, I always been a funny nigga.
Yeah, you know, when you down and out, because that's how you find it. You be like, man, fuck it. I know how to make motherfuckers laugh, though.
I had friends encourage me, man. Shout out to my nigga Jason Van Veen. He, you know, friends encourage me. You know, he tell me the shit I say later when I would rant about how fucked up shit is. He's laughing on the inside. He write this shit down and tell me about it later. And we'll talk about it and go over it. And then I went to the J spot. I did the J spot one night, man. I did that shit, and all I remember is I was nervous as fuck, heart beating out his fucking chest. Like, damn, I'm just gonna do this shit. And I just went up there and told my truth, man. The next thing I remember, the crowd was, that was my best show.
Wow. Your first show was your best show?
My first show was my best show.
That's because you fresh out of jail. That's like when Pop dropped All Eyes on Me.
Yeah.
You had that energy, nigga.
I like,
that nigga just had that energy.
Yeah.
Nigga, I'm free, nigga. That nigga funny as a bitch.
Did you feel like you was fearless? Cause it's like, nigga, I'm out of jail, nigga. I can't lose. I can't fail.
I just left some hyenas.
You feel me? Versus me, I was nervous as fuck because I didn't want to fail.
In a way, I was fearless in that regard, but I was, you know, again, I was very nervous and intimidated because again, this ain't nothing to play with. This ain't, you know, again, if you understand the you wanna make a career out of this, you gotta understand that. You ain't gonna please everybody, but you gotta give it your damage. You can't be no funny duddy. You can't be no just weak ass nigga up there. So I did my shit, man. Crowds clapping and screaming, and I hear Jay just jazz like, Slink, come back here, come on, let me come to the booth, nigga. Come to the booth, come on, let me play. And, you know, when you know, did it again and shit, you know. And after The first few shows, I'm still learning. Like, that first show, it's crazy because the first show had you on high. You like, nigga, I got this.
Uh-huh.
And the second show don't be that
way. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm learning to even it out. Now I can even it out. You know, again, it's a science. Learn to read the crowd. Teddy teaches me a lot.
Teddy teaches me a lot, too. Teddy is a genius.
I wanted to give both of you motherfuckers your roses. I said that ahead of time. You, Lou, you, Teddy, me working, fucking both of y'all for so long, and Lou watching you, your thing, you know what I'm saying? Again, I'm seeing you, bro, and you a student. You just, again, you went from, you know, you had some funny ass videos, but I see your work, bro. This nigga's a comedian, bro, and that shit, I'm in awe of that. And Teddy as well. Teddy is like, he my young homie, but Teddy, you like my sensei, my nigga. I swear to God, like, I feel powerful when we do shows together.
Man, we be having fun.
We do. And we do. And you such a motherfucking talent, bro. Mm-hmm. And you deserve, both of y'all niggas deserve so much, man.
I appreciate
And I dig that y'all fuck with me on the OG shit, but I want y'all to know, when I fuck with y'all, especially on this comedy shit, I'm looking at y'all like, damn, Teddy, I'm gonna go there. Teddy go last. So Lou go after me.
Yeah, exactly.
I ain't tripping. So you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, it'd be nice for Slink, man. This nigga slinking at a rip, bro. I'd be like, nah, man.
Yeah,
cause I ain't got them
kind of
experience,
Slink. Yeah, he got that. Yeah, with just life, but he just done it.
Fuck the kids. Fuck the kids. I'm free. The whole crowd. Fuck them kids. Like, I can't do that. I don't got no kids
yet, man. Them motherfuckers ain't really all they cracked up to be, man. They cute, man, but they cuter when they somebody else's, my nigga.
Right. You hella funny.
I seen an adorable ass baby yesterday, but on the homie, though. It was
you know what I'm saying?
I'm like, oh, this nigga's adorable.
Made your motherfucking heart, man.
I'm not quick to have no kid, because I know what I put my mom and dad through, and I'm like, boy, I know what a bad kid would do to a parent, because I done had my motherfucking mama and dad stressed, man, like a motherfucker. So I'm not trying to get that stressed. So I'm like, I know my kid will fuck around and be bad.
I'll be so on that shit. I'll be telling my son.
You gotta be like, my kid gonna be better. I'll be telling
my son and my daughter that shit when they be lying. Like, do I look like them? I have to call my mom and apologize. I'm sorry for playing you like you was dumb. Because these kids, do you really think I'm fucking dumb, nigga? Whatever the fucking lie you tell me, you lie.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They really, kids really trying to sit up and tell you, kids motherfuckers are the only motherfuckers that eat up your shit, use up your shit, talk back to you, but depend on you for their survival.
Shit, grown niggas do that.
Them motherfuckers with kids, you don't go to jail for neglecting a grown nigga.
Wow.
Mothers, huh?
That's all you care about is going to jail.
I know, right? Everything good. Pandemic, motherfuckers can fall out.
Kids out. I wouldn't be shit to you niggas had I not be threatened with jail.
Facts.
If it wasn't for the court order, I wouldn't even be there. Fucking kid.
That's hella funny, bro.
Wow.
I'm just talking. I'm just saying. This is what I do for a living, baby. I've been talking shit. I got little kids, huh? I don't want y'all to grow up fucked up. Daddy love y'all.
Oh, shit. You hella funny. But that's what that shit about. You know what I'm saying? That's just, you know, that's why comedy is good. Like, you, that's really your gift. And you found it, like, on some, like, nigga, I'm out of jail. Fuck it.
It's them real feelings, man. It's them
crazy.
Real.
Crazy.
I think
early day out.
I think I'm at
that nigga T. Griffin in comedy.
I think I'm at that point, man, where I'm cool with myself. I'm, like, really comfortable with myself, where I can accept and talk about some of my shortcomings. And it is what it is, man. I'm just happy to be in this motherfucker.
That's crazy.
Right down the street right there, it's a nigga that would love to be sitting right here.
Facts.
You know what I'm talking
down
about?
Down the street? On the corner, right?
On the corner. The Woodcock Jail, County Jail is right there. Yeah, it's fucking so.
Damn, for real.
And again, I don't want to make this about jail, because I ain't no jail-ass nigga, no jail-ass comic. But again, just being able to share some different experiences that some of y'all might not have shared. You know, in my years, man, I've seen you done some shit, man. I know some hard living niggas.
Yeah.
Done seen and done a whole lot more, but I've seen and done a lot of shit, man. And I got, look, man, I think y'all, people be having their panties in a bunch for nothing, bro. Just live, bro, because it is what it is. It's going to be what it's going to be, man.
And I feel like that's the part OGs be just really know and really can help the youth with. Because my dad do that shit all the time. I be like thinking like, I be hot about shit, and he be like, nigga, it is what it is. Like, nigga, it's gonna happen, nigga. It's gonna happen again. He be like, God damn, I'm trying to get over this one. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, what a nigga need, though, because it's word of encouragement. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, like, all right, let me just weather this storm.
Yeah, that's what it is, man. She gonna fuck with it. She got two niggas ahead of you already.
Man.
That bitch is leapfrogging niggas. It is what it is, my nigga. Do you love the bitch? That's all that matters. Because if you love her, you're going to be accepting of that shit. And just that's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? So, no, not do you love her, but do you accept it or not? Because it is
accept
what it is.
Accept it or not.
It's
what
it's going to be, man.
Yeah.
Don't be in the bitch falling off. You know the bitch is a recreational dick blower, man. Let the bitch enjoy her motherfucking activities. You know what I'm talking about?
Activities.
It's cool, man. You know what I'm saying? If you like her, you know what I'm saying? You got to just put people in a place where they supposed to be. You got to quit putting people on this pedestal.
Yeah,
you know she's a dirty, low-life dick sucker. So what? She talks sweet. She's a dirty low-life dick sucker. Keep her in that box, man.
A lot of niggas need to hear
but
that.
But I love her.
That's cool, and you can love her. And
this nigga put his head like,
I know, I encourage niggas to love they dick suckers, man. Dick suckers serve a great service to you, man. When I say love her, though, I don't mean wine and dine and romance the bitch, but love her and respect her. Football been something to eat, man. Been sucking all that dick, man. You can get her a little fish sandwich combo from Jack and Crack. Popeye's got a new one, man. Reward the bitch, man. Buy her something to eat, man. These bitches at least, you know what I'm saying? She got me on that dick. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, you can't just take, you gotta elevate the bitch. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my nigga Larry Joe.
Shout out Larry Joe. That's my dick right now.
He fucking Larry Joe. You've
never been so fly.
Yeah.
Man, I've been doing my car dirty as motherfuckers. You can't tell me shit, nigga. Bitch, give me my hat. I'm gonna give it to him. Give me my hat for the bitch. Give me my hat. This is my nigga Larry June. See, I fuck with Larry June because he's a young nigga and he made that.
Oh, so. Young OG.
I ever been so high. I wanna come and choose.
On a pain. Bitch, I feel like I'm dreaming. Yeah.
Bitch, you dreaming. Bitch, you know you fucked up. Now you gotta go back and fuck with broke bruh,
yeah,
bitch.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Bitch, my only problem was you. Oh, man, shout out to Larry June, man.
That's my nigga right now. You know, people be asking me all the time, like, they talk about rap shit with my favorite rapper. Right, my favorite rapper of all time is Scarface. But throughout my life, you know, I got had a lot of rappers. I got a whole, like, I got a, in my life, before I die, I want a motherfucking, nigga hand nigga double album or triple album, whatever, my theme song of my life. But right now, that nigga Larry June.
Wow, that's crazy. Oh, yeah, you got to do the Young OG comedy show, man. We be all the way up to the Bay off all Larry, all play shit.
That's
all
the mirror was the point. Man,
you want to be
on
the
train with Jay-Z, the Carter
album. I'm like, we some playing shit right now. You know what I'm saying? We headed to the studio.
But you know, man, look here, man. I fuck with the Bay, man. I'm rooted in the Bay, man. I've been fucking with the Bay for years. We're too short. You know what I'm saying? He introduced me to, he took me to the town. I was hanging out in the Bay with International with E14.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know your shit.
Doing my shit, man.
Yeah,
you know
that's crazy.
Yeah, man. So I fuck with the Bay, man. I mean, heavy. Mm-hmm. The niggas, hey, man, look here, man.
Yeah.
Look here, you bitch. You know what I'm talking about?
Sometimes I be having a lot of big proud moments. You know, talking about, I had an experience when I was in Atlanta and I was at a strip club and she was trying to get some chicken out of my pocket. You know what I'm talking about? She trying to show me the titties, woo woo. And then I'm like, no, I'm cool though. You feel me? Like, I'm just here just getting the little wings and shit, right? She's like, where you from? And I'm like, I'm from the Bay. She was like, oh, I gotta get away from you because all of the Bay guys that come here tried to pin me. I said,
yeah, bitch.
I had a proud moment. I'm like, I'm trying to figure out who the fake niggas that came before me, because them niggas did everything right.
Yeah,
I'd have to explain that.
She's an asshole.
She got out of here. Yeah, she like, oh, let me leave this thing. I'm like, yeah, I ain't no different.
Or currently laid off, one or the other, because that bitch know. Because don't know, square bitches don't know you ain't supposed to talk to a P.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Square bitches don't know that, so she don't.
Unless she trying to pay the fee.
Yeah,
she left me the fuck alone because I just said an area. I said, oh yeah, them niggas, that was a good Bay moment.
That made your heart smile.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't gotta explain myself. It's like the niggas that came already probably checked her. Like, don't lean, you know what I'm saying?
He went back to the Bay.
Like,
see, the bitch get it. Why don't the world get it?
Yeah.
Damn, I'm in.
You know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, I be having those, that just made me smell, man. You know what I'm saying? Just to know niggas ain't crazy. You know what I'm talking about?
Nigga, the town niggas are some of the most savage player niggas. Like, motherfuckers, like, y'all come down here, y'all talk about L.A. and, you know, the streets. You know, like, you know, again, all streets got to be respected every
Facts.
City. First and foremost, you respect
Facts.
All the streets, every city.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? But the Bay niggas, y'all be all players. Them niggas be savages, though, man. The motherfuckers, the Bay niggas be some cold-hearted savages out there,
too,
man.
There's a lot of sunny bowls out there, nigga, that ain't characters.
Not characters at all.
Nigga, really ride your ass on some animated shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, check it out, my nigga. Like,
and that's the thing.
Nigga, really kill you.
And that's the thing I really love about Bay culture. It's just so, it's electric. Niggas got style with everything they do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's just, I think that's universal being black. But
yeah.
It's a certain thing about the Bay.
It's different in the Bay.
The Bay just, y'all got style.
The same niggas that's in Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
If a nigga grew up in Kentucky, mm-hmm. and then you clone that nigga and make him grow up in the Bay, them is two different niggas.
Yeah. It's two different niggas.
Same right. DNA, but just two different niggas. Like, that culture is a motherfucker.
Yeah, even my dad, because I be talking to my mom and dad, and I'd be like, I'd have been the same nigga no matter where the fuck I was from. You feel me? Off of just my mom and dad, and I'm mixed with them two motherfuckers. I was going to be the nigga in Kentucky or wherever, right? But then the shit that is like, the bad shit, it's like the Bay. My mom and dad didn't teach me all that bad shit.
That's what I'm saying. You feel me?
They didn't teach you the Bay. And then my dad, my mom be like, when I be having my little shoe, my growing pains, they be like, that's just that Bay shit. You gotta stop that shit. You know what I'm saying? These niggas be like, you know what I'm saying? That shit ain't cool. Yeah, but it's saucy though when you on some negative shit. If you being like, not a bad person, but if you on that shit,
you out there doing that
shit. You outside,
you nigga. Shit, you wanna play ball, nigga.
Yeah, when you in the game, you need that game. You know what I'm talking about? But if you like, you trying to, nigga, go to yoga or something, nigga, and free your mind, it's like, you can't be telling the women at the yoga class, like, bitch, chew sometimes them screws up. They be looking at you like, what?
Right, certain places.
The Bay shit don't work.
Everywhere.
All the time.
Drop a Bay nigga off in the
middle. I done dropped some games someplace. And nigga looked at me crazy. I'm like, what? Y'all didn't get that?
Just like a real nigga got to shoot a shot, though. You can put a real nigga in the motherfucking castle in England. He going to shoot a shot somewhere.
And some people just game related. You know what I'm talking about? Absolutely. Niggas just game related no matter where you from. And if you get it, you get it. If you don't, you don't. I don't got the time to explain this shit. You know what I'm talking about? I already said it. Absolutely. Yeah. I'm on some major right now.
Man, they niggas do your shit.
Fuck that nigga.
Man,
is the cat the king if I said what I said? I ain't
gonna
twang shit, nigga. If you don't get the riddle, bitch.
Shit. Oh, that's hella funny. We asked our last guest, 211, about where the furthest place you ever drove for some pussy. I know you a nigga that done a little bit of everything. So I'm curious.
That's why I gotta hit that shit.
Right, he gotta hit the blunt. You gotta smoke yours. You know what I'm saying?
Where I drove for some trip.
What's the furthest you ever drove for some vagina?
I can't tell you what the location because I'll be telling on myself. First of all,
how many hours?
I tell on myself.
How many hours?
Drove.
Just for some
trip. Drove for some trip. Drove.
Do flying count? Did you have something to do out there?
I always got something to do. So I don't even know if this question really counts. Like, the trim be like a big ass cherry on the
That's what I'm saying. Cream. Like that.
Yeah, exactly.
It'd be a big ass cherry. The ice cream might not really be shit, but you know, I'm going to get the ice cream. Yeah. But this big ass cherry.
That sound like somebody's stripper night. Big ass
chair.
Coming to the stage.
You know, OG, explain to something. You starting to get a little lost, like, all right, where the cherry in the ice cream?
The ice cream is gone, nigga. He just gets the butter the whole season.
Like, is the bitch the cherry? And the shit you got to do is ice cream.
Bitch the cherry.
Okay.
Bitch the cherry. So sometimes the ice cream might not be but a small scoop. I'm going to get that. You know, I'm going to get that scoop of ice cream. So I just happen to have a nice big cherry over here that'll roll over here.
I'm not going all the Mississippi to check on family and be like, all right, I'm.
That nigga gonna see his cousin on his daddy's side for 5 minutes and then go fuck with the bitch.
All day.
Oh, man. I probably drove, not far, man. Probably drove a couple hours for some trim.
Like 2 hours.
2 hours. Drove.
Yeah.
Nah, I probably flown.
14?
No, I probably flown. Because Teddy flew. I probably flown about three.
Three. Yeah.
Yeah, like you ain't never flew.
For the pearl?
Not for it.
But
there's some chicken there. It might not be but a strip.
That's off the dribble. It's just, that come with the. That
I often have you went for me. A small strip, but knowing that there was a nice big side of gravy.
Me personally, I'm picky. I don't even like going on vacations because it's like, okay, we gonna go to this restaurant, but then what? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, Me personally, I can't go for one thing, just for anything outside of even vagina. So it's like, I done hit that road though, you feel me? I'm a bae nigga, so you know.
I done hit that road.
You gotta, to what fuck with mean? A girl outside of the bay, you gonna have to hit an hour or two. Right, right, you know what I'm talking about? So,
I get nigga,
it no matter where you leaving from the bay, so if I'm in the town.
Ladies, Oakland ladies, he's leaving you disregarding. Yeah, fuck with me. He yeah. wanna fuck with the bitches in Fairfield. Antioch.
Yeah, Antioch. You know, I gotta be leaving from Antioch and gotta go. You know what I'm saying? That if I'm hitting sack, nigga, that's off the dribble. One hour and 15 minutes.
What we doing? We doing cross.
And you staying the night.
We doing cross. We staying doing cross jurisdiction. So I'm gonna take over the Oakland jurisdiction for you know what I mean. So I cover Oakland for
y'all. You know what I'm saying?
I got the mamas. Hit my phone 310.
They still waiting on the rest of the numbers.
Yes. So LA niggas don't. LA niggas gonna be like, oh man, I'm finna drive to Riverside and get some ass. Cause I feel like I would like, from a bae nigga perspective, Riverside is sack. So it's like, y'all don't fuck around?
Yeah, I mean,
that's an hour right there.
Of course, I mean, absolutely, if she worth it. I mean, if you a real nigga with a car, a lot of these niggas, face it, a lot of niggas have gonna drive to Riverside, i.e. the niggas that talk shit, there's niggas that ain't got no car.
Facts.
Period. Because, again,
that's a good point.
You know what I'm saying? If you're a real nigga, you've been moving around these streets, you're going to meet a bitch that stay in West Covina. You're going to meet a bitch that live in fucking Oceanside. You're going to meet a bitch that live in fucking...
Oh, that's damn near San Diego. That's 2 hours.
Depending on what you got to do out there, it can be a little
niggas bit. Ain't got shit going on the seaside on some wet... That, like...
You never know, bro.
Sometimes you right. Nigga might want some weed or something to seaside.
Sometimes you just got to leave.
People
are traveling
that distance for some bullshit. So, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
too far.
This nigga Loopy grilling the bitch. But what we finna do?
Because
I'm not just finna be
Rich,
coming
to
Oceanside.
Nah, I just thumped down to get the sack. I'll be like, I'm playing with me. If I get the sack, you better not be on no bullshit. Every bae nigga had that mission to sack. You'd be like, boy, if I go out here... You get out there, you get that road, boy. If you 1 in the morning, you trying to get the sack, you get there by 2, you be like, bitch, you better be up.
But up and ready.
And ready. You
know, and that ride there don't be long at all. When you be anticipating that trim, like, damn, I've been waiting to hit this bitch. I've been, ooh.
That's
that
like 15 minutes.
After you done it, and you on your way home at 3:46 in the morning.
That's an accident
attack. Damn. Shit, why I'm fucking with this bitch, dumbass bitch, y'all is way out here. You couldn't wait to get there. You stopped at the liquor store and everything. You couldn't wait.
Oh, wait. Hella, what she smoke? She smoke Dutchess?
That's hella funny.
Let me get some Dutchess.
Oh, that's hella
that
funny.
That ride back be like, man, fuck. Especially, nigga, I took that ride before, you know what I'm talking about, and the trim la-la didn't happen.
Yeah,
the trim la la, and you know a nigga, I be trying to be grown, you know, just you know, the young nigga in me be, man, fuck you, bitch, man, I be mad as a motherfucker. Like, oh, that's cool, baby. So you know, I catch you later, no time. The whole time of ride, dirty ass bitch. I done smoked 4 blunts with this bitch, and she gonna tell me it's raining in Cincinnati, bitch. Fuck you.
If a man go on a burnt mission like that, your ride back. My way be like on some like.
Hey, do you? I feel like okay.
I gotta get something. Now I gotta eat around this motherfucker. Something.
I gotta get something. Somebody gotta give me some pussy. If somebody cat on me. Or...
Oh yeah, you trying to go somewhere else?
Yeah.
Somebody... Now nigga on the pussy tour. Nigga talking, I am over here. That's about
20
minutes from here.
You think about everybody along the way.
Yeah.
You know, if I just go 10 minutes west, I can run it. You know, I just happen to be over here. What you got going on?
What you doing in La Puente? I'm just grabbing something. It's the only A&W.
You know a nigga desperate.
On the motherfucker.
You know a nigga desperate. They just get to the mall. Fuck it. Let me go to the mall and see some bitches. This motherfucker.
That's old school, though. Niggas don't do that no more.
Oh, my, but see, yeah, niggas don't.
Nigga, fuck the mall.
But that's what I'm saying. It's a whole different time of niggas now.
Fuck the mall, the gas station. Nigga, I don't give a fuck the gas station tender. She got some ass behind that counter right there. What's your name, girl?
This nigga. This nigga, the gas that's
y'all niggas be people. Y'all be going for the bitches to just look cute. Go for the useful bitches. Get the bitch to work at the gas station. Get you some snacks and shit. Might put an extra $5 on your little, you know what I'm talking about, little gas.
Man.
Get you a little bitch to work at Wendy's.
You gotta go to Jamba Juice.
You
Starbucks.
Might get a, you might get a 4-for-0 fuck with her. You know what I'm talking about?
4-for-0
You know what I'm talking about? You might get it. Get your bitches. You pretty bitches ain't shit. I want the bitch with the bonnet on, with the little hairnet, with her little stripe, little work shirt on.
With the resources.
With the resources. You pretty bitch don't do nothing but smoke up a nigga weed and eat up a nigga chicken.
It's fuck sexy you. When women at work. I get turned on when a woman at work, well, you looking hella cute at work. When you work, you ain't even gotta have a raw ass job. You just gotta be working.
Let me wash your body off when you come back home. Let me peel that uniform off, bitch, and scrub you down.
Man.
That's gonna be the new movement. I'm telling you, when like all this old crazy ass shaking ass, everybody showing their ass, it's going crazy, but it's gonna start going crazy when bitches start going to work again.
You wonder why it's bad?
Like, you gonna be like, man, it's gonna be sexy in a minute when bitches fully dressed.
That's
like,
awesome. Enough, they got businesses.
Go to work.
Yeah.
Save that's something a- for the imagination. You bitches ain't saving nothing for niggas no more. You giving me your best right there. That's why I don't believe, look, bitch, that's why I like to come in low. I come in fucked up. I want to come in, I ain't got my teeth in. I probably need a haircut. You know what I'm saying? My shoes dirty. And, bitch, if you still like me like that, then good on you, bitch, because it only get better from there. But these bitches, they be
that want to just arrive perfect, and I'm not gonna. What's with the? But I'm gonna really wild out when I get my body done.
I want to see the lack of your.
I'm really start living.
Let me know if you really want to fuck with me for a period of time, and I want to fuck with you. Let me know what I'm seeing. Let me see your cow leg. You know what I'm saying? Let me see, you know, let me see the black
cow leg. That's big with the edges are super missing.
Yeah, let me see the real you so I know what, because again, you get me used to this, bitch. You're not going to wake up in the morning with that weave.
Yeah. Right. If you look like Sherman Hemsley a little bit, that's cool.
I think it should be a movement. I want to see the real you.
I think that's going to become a wave.
I want to see it.
I think the real, but I don't know.
You want ladies, you want real love? Show a man the real you.
Ooh.
Don't look off, nigga. This nigga look
that
off.
That was good.
This nigga. Nah, and then this nigga tried to get the
that three. That was a good one, though.
He tried to get the three like that.
That was a bar.
That was a bar. You know,
that was a good one.
Rewind. See if it was a bar.
Fuck with it. That was a good one. Y'all let us know. Y'all put a comment.
Well, was like that a bar?
It was a bar. Look, well, watch. What's a bar?
Y'all put a comment and let us know. That's a bar. I fuck with it. That was some real shit.
Bar. That was
you
a bar.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, this motherfucker moving up. Oh, we gone.
Oh, this
okay, yeah. Okay. You know,
this nigga short got some freaky shit, baby. This nigga, this bad started to go. Turn into a bag. Yeah, he just hit this motherfucking here. It's gonna be his paw coming out the back.
Shout out to the short man. We at the boom boom.
I said the boom boom. Boom boom room.
Boom boom.
Wasn't that shit called Are You One on the boom boom?
Life.
Raise boom boom. Bro. I ain't ready to be at that one. Like, yeah, I'll get there later, but I'm at the bump box. Boom box.
Got some freaky shit up in here. This nigga's crazy.
Man.
I appreciate you coming, Slink, man.
This is frequency freak.
Look at this nigga. He gonna talk about the titties. Teddy loves
his titties. I know a girl with titties built just like that. She don't got the extra extendo nipple.
I love them.
The extra, like, you know, like, it extends your own.
Well, look at these titties. I took a picture of it. It's so.
Okay. Pull them up.
Thank y'all. Subscribe right now. It's the Kickback. Teddy Ray, Loose Belt, Slink Johnson.
Hey.
Thank y'all, everybody.
Let me see your titties.